Dear students, we have discussed about requirement analysis phase and design phase. So today we will focus on implementation phase. So this was the software development life cycle we were discussing. So we have covered requirement analysis and design. So today we will be mainly focusing on the implementation. So in the previous modules, we have discussed that when we have proper design, then the implementation is not an issue. So in design document, if you have actually prepared a design document in very detail by explaining all of the things and rules and regulations and restrictions and all of these things, semantics and their documentation, so then building the implementation will not be a difficult task. So what is the goal of implementation? It is the actual real-time writing of programs and creation of data files and development of databases. And if you compare it with the construction analogy, which we were discussing in the previous modules as well, so this means that your contractor has been given the design, the structural design, that where he need to raise the wall, and where he need to build the washroom, where he need to build the kitchen. So all of the drawings have been acquired by your contractor in the design document. So now it is very easy to just design, to just implement, to just raise the walls, to just make the floors according to the needs of the customer. So if the design is proper, this means that it is only now some of the work which is required in the implementation phase is just to fine-tune some of the things according to the customer. So if he is liking some color, if he is liking some design pattern, if he is liking some specific, he want to implement things in a different order, in a different way. So those can be done as we are doing in the construction of buildings. So for example, the wall, place of the wall has been decided, but when you raise the wall, so then the customer can tell the contractor that I need to paint this wall using this kind of technology. So such kind of things which are not of very basic or fundamental level can be done in the implementation, but the implementation should be compliant based on the design. So here is another concept of software analyst and programmer. So actually, software analyst is someone who is mainly focusing, who is normally focusing all of the development, but mainly focusing the requirement analysis phase and the design phase. However, the programmer is mainly focusing on the development phase. But in computer science or in computer science community, there is no authority who is controlling all of such terminologies. So you can find someone who is actually analyzing the software, designing the software, and writing the code, and he is just a programmer. He has been given a title of programmer or the senior programmer. Or you can also find someone who is system analyst, but he is analyzing the program, the software, the requirements, and then he or she is designing the software, and then he or she is implementing the software as well. So if we summarize today's module, we have learned about the implementation phase, which is just getting ideas from the design documents and implementing as it is using different programming languages, and then you have achieved your goal. And we have also discussed about software, system analyst, and the programmer.